고난 주간에 빛의 간에 강건한 몸으로 또한 은혜를 사모하는
During this past week,
마음으로 만나게 됨을 먼저 하나님께 감사를 드립니다. 이 순간 죽는 사람이 있는가 하면은 또한 불의의 사고로 육신이 잔만창이 돼서 병원을 찾는 사람이 있는가 하면은 자살 직전에 세상이 괴로워서 하직하는 분이 있는가 하면은 가정이 화목하지 못하고 싸움박질을 통해서 자식들이나 부모들이나 마음의 상처를 입고 사는 분들이 이 하늘 아래 이 땅에 죄악 세상에 얼마나 많이 있습니까? 우리도 같은 사람이지만은 그래도 주시는 은혜와 믿음으로 다 평정을 하나님의 은혜 가운데 만들어 놓고 거룩한 우리 하나님께서 값주고 피로 사신 주의 몸된 교회에 나와서 고난 중간에 예수님의 바자체를 두둥고 또 예수님의 그 마음을 저희들이 각 교회에서 오늘 이 시간에 모였습니다. 고민의 날 첫째가 만찬과 고별사의 기도입니다. 이젠 빛장 안에 오래 있지 못하고 떠날 기약이 갇혀왔죠. 오늘 본문 말씀 볼 때에 놀라운 text, 두 사람을 발견하게 됩니다. 주님의 제자가 예수님한테 유월절인데 준비를 해야 되지 않습니까?
Shouldn't we prepare for it?
오늘 이 유월절이에요.
Today is the Passover.
니사론 14일 때문에.
Because it is the 14th day of Nisan.
예, 주님 보세요.
But look at Jesus.
예루살렘의 성 안에 들어가면은 물동이를 항아리를 한 항아리를
carrying a pitcher of water.
가는 여인이 있다. 무조건 그 여자의 뒤를 따라가서 들어가거든.
And wherever she
선생님이
goes in, go in there with her.
유월절을 지켜야 되는데
our teacher wishes to keep the Passover.
그 방 하나 좀 준비해 주셨습니까? 저 준비한다면은 방이
and
어딥니까?
If they say yes, then also ask where the room will be.
성도 여러분,
dear saints.
아직 성 안에 한 in 여자가 city, 물동어리를 머리에 이고 가지 않습니다.
Carrying a pitcher of water on her head.
미리 본 거예요.
But Jesus foresaw this.
보시고 마시는 분이야.
He always speaks after foreseeing.
그냥 신부름하는 제자가
therefore
참
the disciples who were sent probably
이상하다.
This is so strange. This is so weird.
내가 예루살렘에 도착하려면 그래도 오리 이상을 걸어야 될 텐데 물동이를 이고 간다
so
그 뒤를 따라가라
when I get there, will there be
그리고 선생님께서 이렇게 말씀했다 하라 그 방을 아마 허락해 주고 유월절을
And then the person will tell me, okay, and there will be a room all ready for the Passover. Is this all for real?
This
is probably what they thought when they had left to go. The Bible said so in Luke chapter 14.
누가 14장 12절 말씀 볼 때 유월절의 첫날 곧 유월절 양을 잡는 날에 제자들이 예수께 여쭤오되 우리가 어디로 가서 선생님으로 유월절을 잡수시게 예비하기를 원하시나이까 하매 예수께서 제자 중 둘을 보내어 가라사대 성내에 들어가라. 그리하면 물 한 동이를 가지고 가는 사람을 만나리니 그를 따라가서 어디든지 그에 들어가는 그 집 주인에게 이르되 선생님이 말씀이 내가 내 제자들과 함께 유월절 먹을 나의 갱신이 어디에 있느냐.
그렇게 하는
거라. 예수님이 내일 아침 9시면 처참하게 십자가에 달립니다.
Now Jesus will be brutally nailed to the cross at 9 o'clock in the morning.
예수께서는 눈 붙일 날이 없어요.
Starting from tonight, Thursday, until the next morning, Jesus did not have any break. He was taken to Caiaphas, then to Pilate, then to King Herod, then to the assembly, then back to Pilate.
The Roman soldiers,
their terrifying scourgings,
Judean들의 가르침, 주먹다짐.
The Jews spitting, punching.
그냥 Jesus was dragged around all over
like a beast.
30만 대는 무거운 십자가 내릴 때에 그 나이가 33살밖에 안 되는데 정말 장정 아닙니까?
Wasn't he like 33 year old?
일주일 동안 내내 잡수도 못하고 그냥
now that he hadn't eaten anything
마지막
for a week.
어떠서든 인간 그 죄악을 해결하고 죄를 문제를 완전히 소멸시키기 위해서 속죄 제물로서 십자가에 달리기 전에 미리 그 다 예수님 보는 거예요. 자기가 이렇게 처참하게 사람 대접도 받지 못하고 짐승이야의 그런 취급을 받으면서 고난의 길을 걸어간다고 생각할 때 그 주님의 마음이 얼마나 아프겠습니까? 그때 마지막 두 봉사자를 볼 수 있잖아. 헌신자를 볼 수 있잖아.
But then we see these two people at his service.
Who dedicated themselves.
There is this person who prepared so that Jesus could eat Passover.
And the guest room,
how admirable are they? When Jesus entered Jerusalem, he demanded the colt of a donkey. Tell the owner, our master wants it. And then the owner says, sure, take it.
You see,
they were the last people
who
served Jesus, who worked with Jesus,
who
contributed to this chapter of humankind's redemptive history.
남자 하나하고 여자 하나 아닙니까?
There's this man and woman.
오늘은 예수께서 요한복음 13장 1절 이하에 쭉 말씀 볼 때 사랑하는 제자들에게
받으시겠습니다.
그래서 세족의 날이라.
So today is known 세족. As a Maundy Thursday.
발족자입니다.
Means to wash your feet, Maundy Thursday.
또 한 가지는 거룩한 목요일,
also, it's
목요일.
Known as Holy Thursday.
이렇게 성경을 말씀하고 있습니다.
This is what the Bible says.
그래서 아마 말씀하는 도중에 어제도 한 페이지 반으로 끝났는데
yesterday
이게 뭐
I could finish only 1.5 pages. Today I have 12 pages.
반으로 줄였는데
even that is a half of the 32 pages that I originally had.
대지를 다 적으시기 바랍니다.
I don't think I can cover it all, so please write down the bullet points first.
첫째, First, 유월절 잔치 잔회.
The Passover feast.
출애굽기 12장
Exodus chapter 12,
1절부터
verses
28절.
1 through 28.
15일부터
From the 15th
22일까지
to the 22nd day
일주일간
for one week
무교절 즉 누룩 없는 떡을
먹을 수가 있습니다. It was feast of unleavened bread when they could not eat any bread with leaven or yeast. And that is in Exodus chapter 12 verses 18 through 19.
첫째 날과 제 마지막 7일
of this feast of unleavened bread the first and the last day the seventh day was a holy assembly and everyone was summoned to gather. It's in Exodus chapter 12 verse 16.
그다음에 베드로가 세 번
예수를 Jesus predicts that Peter will betray and deny him three times.
Matthew 26 31절,
verse
31 35절.
Verse 35
마가 14장
Mark, chapter 14,
27절부터
verse 27
31절
through 31.
누가복음
Luke 22,
22장 31절부터
verse 31
34
34
38
and verse 38.
그 다음에는
Next
대제사장으로서의
As a high priest
중보 기도
Jesus interceded
대제사장으로서의
As a high priest
중보 기도
Jesus interceded
오늘 목요일 날
When did he do this? Tonight
요한복음 17장
John chapter 17
1절부터
verses
23 그러니까 마태 마가 누가복음 말씀 볼 때
As written in Matthew Mark
베드로가 예수를 세 번 부인한다는 거
We heard many times that Peter denied Jesus three times
이산 집회, 저교회 집회, 부흥 집회 무슨 사경회
at this revival assembly
각 교단 교회마다 할 때마다 너무 많이 들었어야
돼 We have heard so much about
it.
But today was the actual day when Peter denied Jesus.
Nisan월.
Month of Nisan.
This
is the first month for the Jewish people. For Jewish calendar. In civil calendar, this will be the seventh month. In Babylonian calendar, it was the third month. It's today.
십자가 하루 앞두고 오늘
With only one day left before the crucifixion,
예수님 앞을 보시고
Peter was confident, but Jesus had already seen the future. And saw Peter's actions. He has been there and seen it all, and came back to see all these.
You know,
the fortune tellers, listen carefully.
거야.
The fortune tellers can never go and come back to tell you the truth. They only make predictions. But Jesus. Has actually gone into our future and come back. That's why he has already seen what I'll be doing tomorrow and knows everything. That is why we believe in God.
And
God is not a fortune teller. Fortune tellers cannot go and see and return. But Jesus has. That is why all the prophecies and predictions are always accurate and precise. Nothing is ever wrong. Don't ever forget that Jesus went into your future and came back.
Last
time we studied 1 Kings chapter 13, there was an anonymous prophet who went to King Jeroboam. Now, King Jeroboam was so wicked, he appointed pastors as he wished, and he brought a golden calf to the altar at Dan in Bethel. And he proclaimed that the 8th month, 15th day is a day of freedom. And he fired a priest so that he can burn the incense on himself. So he ended up with withered hand. His hand became withered. In other words, it was paralyzed. So the prophet said, altar, altar. And he said, when you die, Jeroboam, Even your tomb will be dug out and your bones will be burned in fire. Who would do this thing? Among David's descendants, King Josiah will come. This prophecy was for something that will happen 300 years later. 300 years later. He has been to 300 years later and came back. That's how fearful the words in the scriptures are. To this extent, have the astronomers name all the stars? How can we name the zillions of stars in the sky out there, right? But because God himself created all these stars, he knows each and every one of them by its name. So if he calls, hey star, so-and-so, then they all say, yes, sir, and obey. When we see these verses in the Bible, we cannot but fear God and we come with this firm resolution to have a good life in faith. Don't believe with your narrow mind and shallow cleverness. Only searching to please yourselves. Faith is about really believing in God with all your heart. So back to the inside the city. Jesus said, I have to enter Jerusalem. Tell him to give me the colt of donkey and then he will give it to you. See, the disciples didn't tell this to the owner and they just began to untie the colt. So the owner came and said, hey, what are you doing? Why are you taking it? The disciples answered, our rabbi said he needed it. Oh yeah? Oh please then, go ahead and take it at once. See, during the Passion Week, only two people served. The rest of the people, although they had everything, they grudged. They were stingy, and they did not want to dedicate this to the Lord. Even the 12 disciples all ran away. Simon, Simon, the devil has asked for you. Then Peter should have shocked. And he should say, oh, teacher, how come? Why did Satan ask for me? Please pray for me so I will not fall away. He would fall at Jesus' feet and cling onto his feet, begging, right? But he was so arrogant, he stared right back at Jesus and said, oh, don't worry about me. We were with you for 3 years for nothing, huh? I followed you all these years. Yeah, what do you mean that I will betray you in the end? Lord, I will come with you even when you die. I will come with you even to the prison. I am so disappointed that you said this to me. Jesus had already went ahead into Peter's future and came back. After going there, coming back, Jesus saw exactly how pathetic Peter was. Peter could not look into his own future even for a second. And yet, when God foresaw everything, and God spoke to Peter out of love, expecting Peter to grab onto those words, but let alone clinging to him, Peter rejected. He was saying, I am so humiliated. Who does Jesus think I am? How come he doesn't understand my heart? Wasn't he God? Because he is God, he saw Peter's future already and spoke to him. Then Peter should fall to the ground and cling to Jesus' feet and weep and beg to save him. Why did Satan ask for me? Why does he want to take me?
This Passion Week, we must learn this.
Hey, I've been believing more than 5 or 6 or 10 or 20 years. Tell me if there's anyone with a great faith like me at Pyeonggang. You must believe Jesus like me. Why do you come and shake someone up when he's so fine and okay? You know, there are lots and lots of people like this.
All of
people like this must repent. If Satan asks for me, so be it. What about you? Do you expect to never fall into temptations? Always enjoying peace and joy in your heart? Always full of the word grace without an inkling of a sorrow until you go to heaven? Satan will take hold of you and sift you and shake you up. We must also understand this during this Passion Week. Let us read together Luke chapter 22, verse 31. Let's turn to Luke chapter 22.
Verse 31 through 34.
Luke
22,
verse 31 through 34.
이것이 오늘 되어진 사실입니다. 이제 잊지 마세요. 고난 동안에 죽기 하루 전에 그것도 밤에
at night.
네가 높으냐 내가 높으냐
the disciples were quarreling among themselves. Who is greater, me or you? Fighting for power. How pathetic would this be to Jesus?
예수의 마음을 헤아리지 못하고 네가 높으냐 내가 높으냐 이런 권력 다툼 이런 자리 다툼하고 있으니 예수님 볼 때 얼마나 한심합니까?
Who is higher?
다 같이 31절
시작. Simon, Simon, behold, Satan has demanded permission to sift you like wheat.
분명히 예수께서 벌써 아시고 베드로한테 시몬한테 시몬아 시몬아 사다리가 너를 밀가루로 삼을 체다가 흔들지 않게 해. 너 그렇게 하고 있어 사다리가 너를 청구해서
That's exactly
그러면
what Satan
엎드려서 다 주님 다리 붙잡고 자중 말고
살려고 그랬던 거야. Begging him to save him. Shouldn't he? But he looked right back to Jesus' face and said, Jesus doesn't know me.
나를 알아주지 못해.
He doesn't acknowledge me.
저분이 하나님인가?
Is he really God?
한심해 한심해.
How pathetic is
32절.
Verse 32. But I have prayed for you that your faith may not fail, and you, when once you have turned again, strengthen your brothers. And he said to him, Lord, with you I am ready to go both to prison and to death. And he said, I say to you, Peter, the cock will not crow today until you have denied three times that you know me. So he said, the cock will not crow until he has denied Jesus.
A little girl of Peter, when Jesus was interrogated at the court of Caiaphas,
the Bible says, Peter was following him in distance because he's so cowardly. It must have been very cold then. So people were gathering in groups near fire. So Peter was there too. Then this girl saw him and said, Oh, this man is Jesus' disciple too. Peter said, What are you saying, girl? You must be out of your mind. I don't know that man. Someone else says, Hey, this is Jesus' disciple. He denies it again. And the girl said it out louder this time. I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know Jesus is. As soon as he denied Jesus three times, the rooster crowed. This made him realize that Jesus' prophecy was so true. He then fled the scene, and how much did he weep? See, that happened today. Although he wept tomorrow. This happened today.
주님 불쌍합니다.
It was so sad for our Lord. So sorry for him.
유월절은 1년 된 양입니다.
Requires 1 year old lamb.
그 흠이 없어야 돼.
It must have no blemish.
없어야 돼.
No blemish at all.
오후 3시부터 6시 사이에 양을 잡아야 됩니다. 식구가 적으면은 이웃집에 같이 협의해서 한 마리 잡으면 되는 거예요.
And kill one lamb for both of them.
그것이 출애굽기 22장 1절부터 5절에 기록되어 있죠. 유월절 양 먹는 방법은 출애굽기 22장 8절부터 10절에 기록되어 있습니다. 그리고 잘 드세요.
Also listen carefully.
유월절 어린 양이 누굽니까?
Who is the Passover lamb in the Old Testament?
실제 인물 되시는 예수님 아닙니까?
Isn't Jesus the real lamb?
그림자로 상징적으로 구약 때 어린 양. 그래서 요한복음 1장 29절에 세상죄를 지고 가는 하나님의 어린 양을 보라. 요한복음 1장 29절 말씀하십니다. 예수님은 만 인간을 위해서 속죄 제물로서 유월절 하게 하나님의 어린 양입니다.
Although he is human,
사람이지만은 어린 양으로서의 부실을 한 거예요. 오늘 이 시간에 말씀 증거할 때 예수님의 우린 고기를 먹습니다.
Testify these words to you today.
예수의 살을
right
먹는
now,
거예요.
You are also eating Jesus' meat.
주신 말씀 절대 교회 바깥에 집 바깥에 내버리시면 안
never,
됩니다.
Ever send out this word
이게 하나님의 원하시는 법이에요. 하나님의 뜻입니다.
That's God's way that he wants.
고기를 집 밖으로 가져가지
Don't
말라.
Take the meat outside of your home.
요 예언을 잘 지켜야 예수님이 십자가 달릴 때 그대로 이루어지는 거예요. 또 아무리 양이 맛있고
also,
아무리 개구리만 한 사람도 십자가 뼈만큼은
anything,
씹지 말고
깨물지
말고 불을 지 말고 그대로
just as they are.
지키기 바란다. 모세 때
Please observe this. This was spoken
그 모세 때
Moses
이것이 만 인간을 위해서 이 땅에 오신 메시아 그리스도인데
if the Old Testament prophesied clearly that this was actually referring to Messiah
예수님인데.
the Christ who will come for all human race.
그러니까 구약의 예언은 얼마나 좋아요.
If the Old Testament said clearly this land
사단이가 미리 그 비밀을
Christ,
알면 되겠습니까?
So nice. But you see we cannot let Satan to know of this mystery
모세한테도 내용을 대주지 않고 몇 년만 해서
He does not even tell Moses about this.
내가,
God just tells Moses to make the command. Don't let the meat leave the house. Don't chew or break the bones of the lamb.
골고다 언덕에서 예수님 십자가 달리실 때에
was a prophecy
거룩한 성체가
something bad from happening to Jesus' holy body.
잘못될까봐 미리
이어줬습니다.
Jesus' holy body
from being harmed when he was hung on the hill of Golgotha. But the Israelites, they observed that. They did. They obeyed this.
So
let's read together. You see, no prophecy in the Bible was ever unfulfilled. It was all fulfilled. So the question is, why the bones must not be broken? See, when Jesus, the Savior of the world, comes 2,000 years later, then his bones should not be broken because if they're broken then he would become the lamb with a blemish. That would be a violation
200명,
of the redemptive providence. So can you imagine what a suspenseful moment it was for God? There were 2 million or 2.5 million people eating the lamb. If
그 지키는 바람에
if just one
그렇게
person,
믿는 바람에
one adult
예수님 십자가 달려서도
if just one person
마지막
were to crunch
노마
into
군중들이
it would be all over. The end.
좌우편에 강도들을
That's why a strict order was given.
다리 몽둥이를 갖다가
Because they kept it. When Jesus
아니오.
was hung on the cross
우지치,
and the
우지치.
Roman soldiers came
꼬꼬십니다.
to break the legs of the thieves because they could not digest they crushed the leg bones with clubs. Crack, crack. They broke the legs.
So
when they came to Jesus, however, he was already passed away. They held to Jesus' feet, and they were just about to break his legs. But they realized that Jesus was already gone. So they did not break the bones of Jesus. This could happen all because the people had obeyed the word of Moses back in the Old Testament days. And that was fulfilled exactly on the cross. How amazing is this? Let's all turn to Exodus 12.
Verses 46. 46절. 47절을 다 같이 여러분들이 영원히 잊지 마세요.
Please don't ever forget this.
예수 십자가 못 박을 때
When Jesus died on the cross,
좌우편 강도는 죽지 않고 살았죠. 다리 먹은 데가 뼈가 다 부러졌습니다. 예수님은 꼭꼬꼬라고 갔다가 이미 운명하셨어요.
결국
잘 아십니다. 이스라엘 백성들이 그 말씀을 믿고 지키기 때문에
그대로
뜻이
이루어진 거예요.
알았어요. 46절 시작
Verse 46. 자? It is to be eaten in a single house. You're not to bring forth any of the flesh outside of the house, nor are you to break 네. any bone.
이스라엘 중에 다 이것을 뭐요?
And so all the congregation 네. of Israel
자,
are
요한복음
to observe this.
19장 찾으세요.
Now please find John chapter 19.
이렇게 하나하나 깨닫고 가면 좋습니다.
It will be very good for you if you realize one by one like this.
오늘도 전무후무한 은혜가 쏟아지고 내일은 또 쏟아지고 명절 끝날 놀라우신 축복이 있을 줄로 믿습니다.
Amazing blessings on the end of this feast.
우리가 말씀을 잘 깨닫고 순종해야 돼요. 33절서부터 37절까지
Make sure
자 읽겠습니다.
You write this down.
요한복음 19장 33절부터 37절 다 꼭 적어놓으세요. 시작.
The soldiers therefore came and broke the legs of the first man and of the other man who was crucified with him. But coming to Jesus, when they saw that he was already dead,
아, 여기 용서하시고 32절부터 읽읍시다. 그래야 뜻을 알았어요. 32절. 시작.
The soldiers therefore came and broke the legs of the first man and of the other man who was crucified with him. But coming to Jesus, when they saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one of the soldiers pierced his side with the spear, and immediately there came out blood and water. And he who has seen has borne witness, and his witness is true, and he knows that he is telling the truth, so that you also may believe.
36절 시작!
For these things came to pass, that the scripture might be fulfilled, not a bone of him shall be broken.
또.
And again, another scripture says, They shall look on him whom 네, they pierced.
그거 보세요. 또 다른 성경 시편에도 예언이 있습니다.
The Psalm,
알았어요?
Book of Psalm also 그러니까 prophesy about
아까 출애굽기 12장
you know now?
46절 읽었지만 언제 주님 십자가 걸을 때 예수의
when
다리가 꺾어지지 아니한다 뼈가 꺾어지지 아니한다 그 말이 있어요? 없잖아요. 그냥
It does not say
고기를
any of that there, right?
내 하지 말고,
It only
말고,
says, do not let the flesh outside of the house. Don't break the bones. And he says the Israelites all obeyed. But we see John 19 telling us that Jesus' legs were not broken to fulfill the prophecy of the scriptures. And that is today.
여러분들,
this is happening today right now.
Because
you are eating the flesh of the Lord,
여러분,
His word. You are God's holy house. In your house, you have the spiritual meat. The flesh of Jesus must remain in you, in your house.
They should
never go outside of the house. No matter how bad you may feel, no matter everything just that the fight with your spouse, because of this financial issue, you just can't understand each other, and you have fought all day. Still, you must
하나님의 은혜를
you
저버리고
must not forsake God's grace and hurt the bone of Jesus.
뼈를 깎는 그러한 하나님의 뜻에 도전적인 말을 해서는 안 됩니다.
You should never say anything against God's will
조심해야 됩니다.
As if breaking the bones. So please be careful.
누룩이는 떡은 죄를 상징하는
bread symbolizes sin.
나 여러분들은
It's a symbol of sin.
유월절에
During the Passover,
누룩
없는 떡,
무교병
bread.
누룩 없는 떡을
we
우리는
must eat the unleavened
먹고
bread
갈 때까지 먹어야 됩니다
until the day we enter into his kingdom.
죄는 인에 퍼져요
spreads instantly.
누룩은
Because leaven has a fermentability, it quickly decomposes and spreads to the whole lump. See, when you knead the dough, don't put leaven in it.
난 볼 때 딱딱하고
it looks
맛이 없는 것 같죠.
Hard to chew and tasteless.
그걸 무슨 말씀 하냐?
Well, what does this signify? Unleavened bread signifies it's very sincere. Nothing is added.
It's all pure.
It's people too. We have
못합니다.
All this human stuff. You watch TV and whatnot. You learn from it. But they're not sincere or innocent or pure. Learning from these worldly things, they all become so cheeky and insolent. like wicked fish.
불안 중간에 우리 눈으로 없는 떡을 먹고 있으니 순수한 sincerity, 신앙을 가지시길 바랍니다.
I pray
고린도전서 5장 7절 8절 적으면
되겠습니다.
그분 6월절에 또 뭘 먹었느냐? 쓴나물을 먹었습니다. 쓴나물
눈으로
없는 떡하고 쓴나물 먹고 정말 생각하면요 이해가 안 가죠.
어떻게
누룩 없는 단단한 그 밀가루 떡을 먹고 맛대가리 있습니까? 없죠. 더군다나 이렇게 감미로운 이러한 나물을 먹어야지 쓰디 쓴나물 말이죠. 양념도 하지 않고 말이야. 고역이야 고역.
Without any seasoning.
그걸 먹으래.
What a torture it was. They were told to eat that.
광야 사막을 통과해야 될 텐데.
They had to eat it because
40년
now
동안.
They are about to pass through the desert.
될 텐데.
That represents the hardships of the 40 years in this desert. They must never forget the hardship and the suffering.
우리 평강 제일교회.
Same thing.
진심으로 주님의 이름으로 믿음으로 고난 중간 주님의 바자지를 따라가고 있습니다.
We are really
오늘 우리 비로소 쓴나물을 먹습니다. 그 때문에 앞으로 사업이 안 된다, 가정 가운데 갈등이 있다, 새끼가 솔생긴다, 뭐 내 돈 다 떼어먹었다, 그냥 겹치고 덮치고 그냥 도저히 헤어날 길이 없어.
유혹절날에
쓴나물을 먹은 줄 알고 고난에 사막 같은
know,
먼지가 날리는 그런 길을 걸은 줄 알고 신앙을 저버리지 않고 믿음으로 끝까지 기도하고 하나님께 부르실 때 반드시 하나님께서 우리의 생각 밖에 큰 기적을 우리에게 시도하실 줄로 믿으시기를 바랍니다. 그 때문에 성도는 십자가를 주어야 되며 고난 중 때
That is why a believer must carry his own cross.
십자가 진다는 것은 누룩 없는 사람만 지는 거야.
Only those without leaven can carry.
누룩 없는 떡을 먹은 사람만 지는 거야.
Only those with unleavened bread.
세상에 요것도 배우고 저것도 배우고 배우고.
People who have learned this and that from the world, who have become so cheeky and smart.
세상에 그냥 차돌 모양으로 너무 부러 먹어주던 단계 일반지네.
Around all of the world, you become so sleek and smooth.
시장에
Like those wandering vendors who become so good at selling after decades of cheating here and there. We the believers have eaten bitter herbs. So even when the hardships come, you say, Lord, is your path for the gospel, the path for your will, is this path the path of hardship?
그렇죠.
Like bitter herbs like this.
누룩 없는 단단한 yes. 밀가루 떡을 먹었습니다. 보리 떡을 먹었습니다. 맛대가리 없습니다.
No taste at all.
그냥 십자가는 그런 사람을 지는 거야.
Only such people can take up their cross.
돈만한 사람 못죠. 권력, 명예,
take the cross. People with power, prestige,
내로라는 사람 절대 못 집니다. 그 십자가 채웠습니까?
Would they be willing to take the cross?
말씀도 안 했어요.
If it was that easy, Jesus would not even have to say it.
십자가 진다는 것은 죽음의 길이야.
Taking up the cross is path of death.
항변을 못합니다.
You cannot protest at all. You cannot protest. You cannot complain. Just silence.
이게 십자가
silence.
저거 생각해 바랍니다.
This is the path of the cross. Please write this.
주님 바자지를 따라가는 길은
following the steps of Jesus
땅과
as the path
눈물과
of sweat tears
수많은 장애물
countless obstacles
고난에
and suffering
늘 참여하는 길이다. 누가 9장
Luke chapter 9,
23절
verse 23
갈라디아 3장
Galatians chapter 3,
1절부터 4절
verse 1 through 4
빌립보 1장
Philippians chapter 1,
29
verse 29
3장
chapter 3, verse
10절과
10,
11절
verse 11
베드로전서
First Peter,
4장
chapter 4,
12절과
verse 12,
13절
13.
참 주님의 가신 길은 그렇게
Truly,
쉬운 길이
the
아닙니다.
Way Jesus took was not easy.
결단코 쉬운 길이 아니에요.
It was absolutely not easy.
아주 어려운
It
길이죠.
It was very, very difficult.
정말 어려운 길입니다.
Really difficult.
여기 빌립보 1장
Let me read Philippians
29절 제가
chapter
읽겠습니다.
1, verse 29.
그리스도를 위하여
For to you,
너에게 은혜를 주신 것은
has been granted for Christ's sake.
예수님을 위해서 여러분들에게 은혜를 주신 것은
grace has been granted for
돼지가 갑자기 왜 살찝니까
Why
돼지가
do pigs get fat all of
여러분
sudden?
집에서 기른 pigs. 돼지가 갑자기 왜 살찝니까
When do your pigs at your barn get fat so suddenly?
이유가
Because you fed them well.
아들, 딸,
There's reason why you feed them well, right? Because the wedding date for your child is approaching.
그렇잖아요?
Isn't that true?
아들, 딸,
you have to marry off your child.
돼지
so you have to kill the pig, right?
잡으려면 잘 먹여야 되겠죠?
Kill it, you have to feed it well first.
마찬가지로
Likewise,
그리스도를 위하여
for to you,
너에게
grace has been granted for
예수 때문에
Christ's
나 여러분에게 은혜를 주신 것은 그만입니다. 다만 그를 믿을 뿐만 아니라 다만 예수를 믿을 뿐만 아니라 또한
It's not only to
예수를
위하여
고난도 받게 하십니다.
Suffer for his
그래서 은혜 주는 거야.
That is why God is granting you the grace.
하나님,
oh God,
은혜 받았는데 왜 이렇게 집안이 어려움을 당합니까?
But why is my family
아이고,
such hardship?
하나님이 이거 나 버리고 이제 나 필요 없습니다.
Whether it is you or other God, I don't care anymore.
말씀 받고 은혜 받고 기도했는데 왜 집에 어려움이 시험만 닥치네?
I prayed. Why does my family only keep having all these trials and hardships?
예, 적어두면 좋아.
It will be good for you if you write all this down.
얼마 좋아요.
How wonderful is this?
참 이건 내가 지금까지 직장인 월급 다 때려치고 그냥 이 말씀 소리 하다가 예수님 책임지고 내일 몽땅 다 입혀서 하나 올라간다면요 내일까지 할만 하지만은
Yes, we can do that if we Jesus takes all the responsibility and take us all to heaven tomorrow morning. We can keep going like this.
요새 고난이 없어서 이거 안 쉬는 날인데.
We have kids, we have family, we have work. And they could not fire you at work because you showed no flaws to this day. But if you're late to work now, wouldn't that be trouble? So you wrote down everything, right? How wonderful is this?
어린양을 먹되 종발에다가 예 종발에다가 양의 피를 담았잖아요.
Now they took the lamb's blood in a bowl.
이게 우설처럼 그 있어요.
Then they dipped a hyssop.
Hyssop
into the blood and painted the doorposts and lintels both sides. They painted it with the blood.
그러면 죽이는 사자
then the angel of death comes.
천사가 오죠.
He kills only
죽여,
the firstborn.
짐승의 첫 새끼,
whether it's a firstborn,
사람의
human,
첫 새끼.
Or animals.
그냥 집집마다 들어가서
the angel of death goes into the house
거야.
And kills all firstborn.
그러니까 애급천지의 성경에서 볼 때 곡성이 진동한다고 했어요. 어느 집은 죽고 어느 집은 안 죽고 안 죽으면 도대체 위로 받아. 근데 다 죽었어요.
문방에
대문에 임방에다가 피를 바른 집은 천사가 그 집 안 들어갔어요. 대문에 문방에 예, 임방에 피가 없는 집, 어린 양의 피가 없는 집은 들어가서 다 죽였어요. 바로 왕의 클라드스부터 다 죽였어요.
Did the angel go in and killed? Starting from the firstborn of King Pharaoh.
그래서
the angel killed them
사도 바울도 나 예수의
That's why
피 묻은
Apostle Paul said,
옷을 입었는데
I am wearing the robe of the blood of Jesus.
예수의 흔적을 가졌는데 나 더 이상 저렇게 하지 마라.
I have the mark of Jesus. So leave me alone.
내가 세상에 대해서 못 박았어.
I have been crucified against the world.
너도 나에 대해서
Why do you keep afflicting me? All you have to do is to be crucified against me.
나 세상 싫다는데.
I told you I don't like
the world. 나 세상 내가 믿지
않겠다는데. I will not
believe in the world. 왜 세상이 나에 대해서 괴롭히냐 말이야.
Why does the world afflict me?
더 이상 괴롭히지 마.
Don't afflict me anymore.
바울의 결론이 그겁니다.
This was Paul's conclusion. So I pray.
몸에 죽음의 사자가 들어오지 않도록 예수 그리스도 하나님의 어린 양 십자가 흘리신 보배 피를 전부 다 바르시기를 젖으시기를 주의 이름으로
축원합니다. 젖으시기만
성경 성경
all we have to do is that we are soaked in his blood. That's what the Bible testifies.
이 피를 부정하게 여기고 여기서 발로 밟으면은 발로 밟아치면 자손만 대 망합니다.
히브리
10장 29절 집에 가보시면 알 거예요.
If you read this when you go home, you will know.
속죄의 상징 죄를 사해 주는 것이 피 속에 생명이십니다. 권세와 능력이십니다.
That forgives your sin is a life inside the blood. It has a power and authority. So please
발랐다.
listen carefully.
이렇게
it's that you put the
발랐다.
blood of Jesus on you like this.
그러면 이 피가
Then this blood
나를 위해서
will speak on my behalf.
내가 미처 깨닫지 못하고
when I don't understand,
기도 못하고 회개
when
못하는
I don't pray,
거. 또
when I don't repent,
어떤 악한 것들이 와서 나를 모략 음모해가지고 주랄 때 이 피가 먼저 하나님 앞에
초래칩니다.
하나님
God,
내가 뭘 먹고 있는
master,
내가
so-and-so,
달리고 있는
serving,
주인자는 아무개 그분
this master has no sin.
이 피가 증거를
See, this blood on you will testify for you.
피소리가 얼마나 큰지 압니까?
Do you know how loud the cry of blood is?
피야.
Jesus' blood is the blood of life. It's alive. Jesus' blood is the blood that speaks. Better than the blood of Abel, the son of Adam, is the blood of Jesus. Even Abel's blood spoke.
죽였어요.
Cain killed Abel.
가인이, 형님이,
Cain was his older brother.
동생 아벨 제사를 하나님이
받고 brother Abel's
형님들은
offering,
가인 제사를 안 받았죠.
Cain, the older brother.
인간의 생각으로
so
너 새끼 없으면 내 거 받았을 텐데
he weren't there, God would have accepted my offering.
안 보는데
and dragged Abel out to the wilderness when nobody saw and he struck Abel's head and killed him.
하나님밖에 없어.
Did no one except God see this?
하나님 왜
was there nobody to see this? Absolutely not.
아버지
The life in the blood of Abel saw it.
너무 억울해, 우리 주님.
It was so unfair for my master.
너무 억울해.
It was so unfair that this blood that was shed on the ground, this blood spoke to the ground, saying, Mr. Ground, yes,
let me borrow your mouth.
The blood spoke to the ground.
So
the ground heard the blood and said, okay, I will open my mouth for you.
Then,
who spoke after the ground opened its mouth? The blood appealed to God.
God
was startled when Abel's blood spoke through the borrowed mouth of the ground, and God heard it all.
성도 여러분,
Dear saints,
그렇다면은
if
오늘
so,
유월절 어린 양
today
먹었습니다.
You have eaten the lamb of the Passover.
여러분들의 대문이 임방의 피를 발랐습니다.
Doorpost and lintel.
올라가지 수십 년 예수 믿으면서 이렇게 똑똑하고 정확하게 말씀을 듣고 깨닫는 거
so clearly,
복중에
so precisely,
하나님 앞에
this is the greatest blessings.
영광 돌리고
give all the glory to God and truly give yourself
to
God as sacrifice of thanksgiving.
창세기
Let's read Genesis chapter
4
verse 8.
8절
verse 8
피가 소리 질러 피가
the blood
여러분들
shouts.
몸에 바른 예수의 피가
the blood cries
여러분을 지키고
the blood
알았어요? 이 예수의 보배로 피가 썩지 않았습니다. 썩었으면 인간이
못 시켜요.
못 시킵니다.
It cannot save
지금도 싱싱하게 살아있는 피입니다. 알았어요?
It is so alive and working even now.
주의 십자가 피의 권세
Make sure to sing the power of the blood of Christ, the Lord's precious blood that is so holy, so immortal, this life-giving blood. May that blood cover me just twice. Please pray like that. Don't wait until you're dying to pray. Pray while you're healthy. Pray like me, always. After I realized this will of God, never one day in my life did I forget to give thanks for this precious blood on the cross and pray. I am always so thankful. Yes, I am covered with the Lord's precious blood. And this blood is keeping me. This blood is embracing me. Always appealing to God for my sake. Always protecting me. This is sacred blood of life. I don't know how to speak, but Lord, I believe that the word that is in my blood will speak to you. I believe like this. This is a whole different level. On the outside, the person believes in Jesus. This person believes in Jesus. But when spiritually looking at the person's heart and understanding, everyone varies. That is why there is a heaven and earth gap among people who all say they believe in Jesus. What if you didn't come today? Although you have believed for 30, 20 years, how can that make you any better?
Maybe there's someone who can believe in me for a short time,
but by listening to this word, they understand this message more than those who have been Christians for 30 years and have never listened to this word. Know for certain that you have listened to this word and go ahead of those who have not listened. The first will become last. The last will become first. This word was teaching. This word was to teach you just this.
창세기 4장 8절서부터
Let's read from Genesis chapter 4, verse 8.
시작.
And Cain told Abel, his brother, and it came about when they were in the field that Cain rose up against Abel, his brother, and killed him. And the Lord said to Cain, Where is Abel, your brother? And he said, I do not know. Am I my brother's keeper? And he said, What have you done? The voice of your brother's blood is crying to me from the ground. And now you're cursed from the ground, which has opened its mouth to receive your brother's blood from your hand. When you cultivate the ground, it shall no longer yield its strength to you. You shall be a vagrant and wanderer on the earth.
보세요.
Look here.
가인아, 네 아우,
Cain, where is your brother?
난 몰라요. Says, 내가 아비를 지키는 자입니까? 딱 그랬을 때 야야야 땅에서 입을 벌려가지고 너희 동생 앞소리가 나한테 말해서 호소했어.
응?
이게 얼마나 무서워요. 이 영의 세계를 영적인 모르기 때문에 전부 다 눈만 깜짝깜짝하고 벌써 예수 믿어도 재미없습니다. 맞아. 믿어봐야 그날이 그날이고 오늘이 내일 같고 내일이 오늘 같고 그런 맥이 없어.
맞아.
교회 안 나오면 또 뭐 하나 잊어먹는 것 같고 또 짐작 같아. 그러니까 어쩐 미신적으로 나오는 거 이렇게 시계 중앙으로 왔다
갔다가 like a pendulum in clock come and go come and go.
시간을 몰라 시계 중앙
you know the pendulum doesn't know what time it is. Okay.
이렇게 믿는 사람 많이 있어요.
So many people believe like this.
답답해. 내가 봐도 답답한데.
How frustrating is this? It's frustrating even for me to see.
그러니까 예수의 피는 아벨의 피보다도 낫다니까.
Is better than Abel's blood.
히브리서 12장 보겠습니다.
Hebrews chapter 12 verse 24. Hebrews chapter 12 verse 24.
24.
Verse 24.
히브리 12장 24 찾았죠?
Verse 24. Did you all find it?
다 같이
Let's read together. Ready?
자.
Begin. And to Jesus, the mediator of a new covenant, and to the sprinkled blood.
예.
Which speaks better than the blood of Abel.
예수의 피보다 낫다고 했죠?
It says right here that Jesus' blood is better than Abel's, right? Then wouldn't Jesus' 네? blood cry out even louder?
예수께서도
Jesus
마태복음 23장 찾으세요.
Please find
35절 시작.
That upon you may fall the guilt of all the righteous blood shed on earth, from the blood of righteous Abel to the blood of Zechariah the son of Berechiah, whom you murdered between the temple and the
보세요.
altar.
그래서 예수님의 어린 양의 피가 얼마나 귀하다는 거. 예수의 피를 짓밟고 예수의 피를 무시하는 자 잘 기록습니다.
Looking down upon Jesus' blood, there is no way for life for such people. God said, you are born again, not by perishable seed. No matter what sin there is, the sin will tremble in fear at the sight of Jesus' blood on the cross. It will all melt away at a single look on the cross. They will all vanish. At such, Jesus' blood is the blood of all blood, so we can call it the precious blood, as written in 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 18.
그래서 피를 먹지 말라고 했죠.
That's why we must not eat the blood. Leviticus chapter 17 verse 11.
피가 죄를 사해 준 게 아니라
It's not the blood itself that atones for sins.
그 생명이 우리를 사해 준다.
Is what atones,
피는
but
생명의
forgives our
보장입니다.
Sins.
보장이.
The blood is like a cloth that wraps the life. Like a wrapping cloth for life.
예수께서 하나님께서 모세한테 모세야
God spoke
to Moses. 내가 어린 양 피가 너 문지방 문방에 발라 있으면은 내가 그 보고 넘어갈게. 그래서 넘어갔다. 그래서 유월절이야. 유월이야. 넘어간 거야.
Because God passed over.
믿음으로 다 집에 교회 붙이면
돼요.
또 여러분들 마음 가운데 자신 있게 예수 믿음을 자랑하세요.
Be confident in your heart that you believe in Jesus.
우리 집은 어린 양 예수님의 피가 발라 있는 피가 묻어 있는 집이다.
나서
믿는 대로
되리라. 그렇게
믿지 않기 때문에 안 되는 거지.
그
믿음은 그대로 믿습니다.
I believe it will happen to you just as you believe.
믿지 않다고 오만가지 다 그러는데, 아 십자가 거리난 것만 갖다 붙여봐.
Either even the unbelievers wear a cross, right? So if you put the cross up, then even the demons come nearby. They get all scared and they run away. This is the house of the blood of Jesus Christ. If I go in, my head will be shattered and crushed. Even the Beelzebul will see it and run away.
넘어가리니 절대 너희 집에 재앙이 임하지 아니한다. 출애굽기 12장 13절 말씀이야.
Not before your house. This is in Exodus chapter 12 verse 13.
재앙이 여러분들 집에 안 가겠다니 뭐래?
No plague will come near your house. So what's the worry?
아유, 이렇게 하다가 다 못합니다.
I will never finish.
아, 적으세요.
Please write this down.
제자들의 발을 씻김.
Jesus washed the disciples' feet.
요한복음 13장 1절부터 20절.
John chapter 13 verses 1 through 20.
발을 씻기 전에 먼저 누가 22장 24
Before the washing of the feet, first,
주님의 심정을 헤아리지 못하고 네가 그냥 내가 그냥 싸움 박질을 하고 난 다음에 발을 씻겼습니다.
And they were fighting who is greater. After that, Jesus washed their feet.
누가 14장 10절 적으세요.
Luke chapter 14 verse 10.
청함 받았을 때에
When you're invited, don't go and sit at the high place. It's more embarrassing if you took the high seat, but get kicked out into a lower seat, right? So Jesus says, be humble. Proverbs chapter 15, verse 33, he says, before honor comes humility. The purpose why Jesus came to this earth is to serve.
누가 22장 27
Luke chapter 22 verse 27
마태 20장 28
Matthew chapter 20 verse 28
예수와 같이
If we
동고동락하게 되면
live and eat 왕으로 with Jesus 왕으로. We become kings.
누가 22장 30절
Luke chapter 22 verse 30
대모대후서 2장
Timothy,
12절
chapter 2 verse 12
제자가 주님의 발을 씻어야 될 텐데 성지님이 제자 발을 씻으시니 예수님의 겸손 보세요 겸손 내리면 돌아가셔 얼마 마음이 여유가 있습니까 얼마 제자들이 마음이 못돼서 이놈 이놈들이 말이야
내리면 십자가 달려 돌아가신 발인데
그 다 잊으시고 당신 아픔 잊으시고 사랑하되 끝까지 주님의 제자를 사랑하는 주의 모습 보세요.
And he's loving the disciples to the very end. Look at the love of Jesus. John chapter 13 verses 1 through 5.
그 다음에 유월절 잔치는
the supper of Passover.
순간이라도 같이
it was for
있고
Jesus to be
같이
with them.
먹기 위해서
even just for a moment, even just for briefly, to be with them, to eat with them. Tomorrow he will leave them, right? So he was so grieved for leaving them.
내년 당신은 처참하게 죽지만은 사랑하는 제자만큼은 똘똘 뭉쳐서 다락방 강원을 해야 될 거 아닙니까? 자녀들의 마음들이 하나로 묶어서 앞으로 하나님의 뜻에 육하는 귀한 존재가 되기 위해서 주님
Look what Jesus does to bond,
같이,
bind their hearts so tightly
그것보다,
to become, to make, to become, so the tiny,
누구,
so that they can
become
a precious instrument
to fulfill
God's will
in
the future. Jesus says, "I so want to be with you. I so want to be with you." Luke 22 verse 15. I have earnestly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer.
너희와 함께
leave,
내가 유월절을 같이 먹기를 원하고 원하노라
earnestly desired earnestly desired he repeats himself twice
나도 여러분 떨어지기 싫은데
I don't want to be away from you
눈만 뜨면
so
교회
every moment I'm
눈만
awake,
뜨면 기도
I think of church.
눈만 뜨면 설교
every waking moment I preach Every waking moment I pray.
평생 극장을 갑니까?
Do I ever go to
the
theater?
무슨 오락입니까?
Do I have friends?
화통 못하죠.
What recreation do I do in my life?
장애발 못하죠.
I can't play cards.
골프 못하죠.
Can't play chess.
볼링 못하죠.
Can't play golf. Can't go bowling.
아, 여러분의 속이고 내가 육신적으로
yeah,
생각하면 하려면 할 수 있죠.
And do them all if I wanted to.
그건 하나님의 뜻에 그런 거 들어 있지 않아?
But those things are
not have
any part in God's will. This have nothing to do with God's will, so what's the use of pursuing these things? So I don't.
적으세요.
Please write
마태복음
down.
26장
Mark
17절부터 25.
17 through 25.
마가 14장
Mark 14.
17절부터 21. 누가 22장
Luke 22.
7절부터 13.
7 through 13.
요한복음 13장
John chapter 13.
21절부터 30절. 내가 고난을 받기 전에 너희와 함께 유월절을 먹기를 원하고 원하노라 이 말씀 잊지 마시기 바랍니다.
Don't forget this word ever and ever.
그러면서 참 같이 있고 같이 먹기만 하는데 예수님이 유다의 앞을 갔다 왔어요. 한 수대 밥을 먹는 사람이 나의 발꿈치를 든다 본다
Someone who has been together with us will raise his heel against me. This is what has been prophesied in the Old Testament. The psalmist did. One of you is son of a devil. He will betray me. So at the Last Supper, as he was observing the Passover, Jesus was saying this in his Last Supper. Can you imagine his heart?
요한복음 13장
John chapter 13,
21절
verse
21절
21 through 22.
마태 26장
Matthew 26
21절서부터 30절
21 through 30.
요한복음 13장
John 13
26절서부터
verse 26
30절
through
30.
He gave
Judas
the bread and Satan entered Judas. And then Jesus said to Judas, there's something that you want to do, right? What you do, do quickly. You took money, you said you received 30 pieces of silver and you said to them, sell me to them. You said that, right? Go out and do that quickly. That's written in John chapter 13, verse 21.
오늘 밤에 그런 일이 벌어졌어요.
This is what happened tonight before midnight. Around 10 o'clock tonight, that's what Jesus said.
그러니까 요한복음 13장 2절 말씀 볼 때
so in John 13 verse 2 it says the devil has already put into heart of Judas Iscariot to betray him.
벌써 그 마귀가 가룟 유다한테 예수를 팔려고 하는 생각을 넣었어요.
The devil already put the thought of betraying Jesus into heart of Judas.
나가서 너 그리 빨리 주지.
Jesus says, "You have made this promise. You're gonna sell me, turn me over."
예수의 마음이 얼마나 아팠을까?
What you do, go and do quickly. Can you imagine the pain in Jesus' heart when he said that?
요한복음 13장 2절에 기록됐습니다.
That's recorded in John chapter 13, verse 2.
나가자세요. 내가 할 일을
보소하라. Repeat after me. What you do, do quickly. John chapter
13, verse 27.
Judah, there's something that you want to do, right? Go out and do it quickly. You took the money.
So
go and take up your role as an informer, pretending to lead the way for me. He said this around 10 o'clock tonight.
적으시기 바랍니다.
Please write this down.
마태 26장 24절.
Matthew chapter 26 verse 24.
다 같이 읽겠습니다.
Let's read this together.
유다가 왜 이 세상에 태어났습니까?
Why was Judas
예수
born
말씀을
in this world?
우리 똑똑히 알아냈습니다.
We must clearly understand what Jesus said.
마태 26장 24절
Matthew chapter 26 verse 24 The Son of Man is to go just as is written of him. But woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been good for that man if he had not been born.
차라리 세상에 나지 않았다면 넌 죽을 뻔했다.
It would have been good for that man if he had not been born.
오늘 이 시전에 하신 말씀입니다.
Jesus said this tonight before 11 o'clock.
주님 될 구원의 십자가 아침 9시 다르시는데
We must know the Lord will be hung on the cross at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning on Friday. And this is what the word Jesus spoke in the upper room of Mark John at 10 o'clock at night. When you think about this, we must believe well. We have no time, so let's write this down. There's Jesus' final sermon, his farewell sermon. John chapter 13, verse 32-35.
14장 chapter 14, 1절부터 31절.
31,
15장 chapter 15, 1절부터 27. 16장 1절부터 13절. 그다음에 대제사장으로서의 중보기도.
Intercession as a high priest. John chapter
읽었습니다.
17, the whole chapter.
그러니까 요한복음 13, 14,
John chapter
16,
13,
15, 16,
14,
17은 금요일 밤에 다 하신 말씀이에요.
네, 그걸
내가 알아야지.
You must understand this when you read this.
전에 하신 말씀이 아닙니다.
This is the word that Jesus spoke.
이 성경 읽을 때마다 참 전율이 나고 정말 치가 떨릴 정도로
you feel this electric shock in your body.
You're
trembling really. And you also feel so sorry for Jesus. So please remember this well. And I pray that you live a life without shame before God. And I bless you in the name of the Lord.
적으세요.
Please write this down.
누가 22장 31절
Luke chapter 22,
시므나
22.
시므나
Simon,
조심하라
Simon.
하세요 그 이름을 반복했죠 시므나 시므나 그 다음에 누가 10장 38절서부터 42절
Twice. And also Luke chapter 10 verse 38 through 42.
마르다야, 마르다야 좀
Martha.
세요.
He called the name twice.
필요한 일은 다만 하나밖에 없다. 그 하나를 가르치기 위해서 예수께서는 이름을 반복했습니다. 마르다야,
In order to teach her of that 마르다야. one thing that is necessary,
하나.
Jesus called her name 마르다라. twice. Martha, Martha, twice. Jesus, Martha did not know this one.
그 다음에 사도행전 9장 4절 좀 보세요.
Also write down Acts chapter 9 verse
사울아,
4. Jesus called
사울아.
Saul and Saul.
핍박자 살인자를
Jesus was calling
전도자로
the persecutor,
부르시기
the
위해서.
murderer, to become his preacher.
그 다음에 창세기 22장
also,
11절 좀 보세요.
Genesis chapter 22 verse 1.
창세기 22장 22장
11절
아브라함아
아브라함아
Abraham, 왜 부르냐
Why did
믿음의
God call
조상 삼기 위해서
to make him
너무 감사해요
the ancestor of faith. How we are so thankful for this.
그 다음에 마태 23장
Then
37절 좀 보세요
예루살렘아 예루살렘아 Jerusalem.
너무 불쌍해서
because he was so
sorry
생각하기
때문에 왜
because he so
loved the
nation
불쌍해하기 때문에
why because
눈물 흘리면서
the nation was racing toward its destruction
고대회 사무엘상 3장 10절 적으세요
2 Samuel chapter 3 verse 1
사무엘아
Samuel,
사무엘아
Samuel
그 뜻은 암흑 속의 허덕이는
was to save the Israelites
이스라엘 백성들을 구원시켜
struggling in darkness
하나님의 선택된 백성을
창조해서
그렇다면 오늘 예수께서 마음이 민망하여 죽게 되는데 저를 비롯한 여러분들 각자 이름을 부르면서 이금자야 황금자야 뭐야
Peter,
다 이름을 부릅니다
David,
다 불러
Paul,
어?
He calls
다
all
불러
our names out.
참 예수님 이렇게
right now,
부르시면서 가는 거예요 우리를
Do you understand
알았어요
Jesus
각자 이름을 부르면서 가는 거예요
as he goes.
나는 십자가 안에서 너희 죄 때문에 해결하라 가지만은
I am going
여러분 각자 이름을
암흑이에요
암흑이에요 이런 영험을 들 줄 알아 알아야
you
됩니다
must be able to hear the spiritual voice.
알아야 돼요 아이고 끝이 없습니다
oh,
하나만 더 읽고 말씀 마치겠습니다
Let us read one more and then we will end.
조심하죠
We must really be careful.
자 찾아요. 고린도전서 3장
chapter
3 1절부터 2절까지
verses 1 to 2
And
I, brethren, could not speak to you as to spiritual men, but as to men of flesh, as to infants in Christ. I gave you milk to drink, not solid food, for you were not yet able to receive it. Indeed, even now, you are not yet able.
자, 보세요.
You see?
어? 참 신령한 자 되어야지 영적으로 되어야 될 텐데
We must become spiritual men. But we're all people of flesh. We're too fleshly. So even if you receive deep words,
you
don't understand. Rather, you just throw it up, throw up the word. You cannot eat solid food and cannot drink. You cannot eat solid food. You can only drink. You can only drink milk. You cannot eat solid food or cooked meals. We must not become such people. We have believed Jesus for decades. But Jesus sent him as he said, let us go. He doesn't call our name just once, but twice. You know, my name is Yunshik, so God calls Yunshik, Yunshik. Please believe this. And as Jesus took his last
step,
he didn't forget me, but he called me. Jesus loved his disciples to the very end. To the very end. Let's read John chapter 13, verse 1 again. We don't have time to cover everything.
요한복음 13장 1절 이건 다 읽으시기 바랍니다.
We'd like to ask everyone to read this.
1년자는 꼭 그렇게 될 거예요.
Because if you read it,
읽으세요.
This will happen to you.
Okay? 읽어.
Please read.
뭐 찾아서 읽고 찾아서 읽고.
You read whether you even if you can't find the verse, you read.
다 같이 요한복음 13장 1절
시작. Now before the feast of the Passover, Jesus, knowing that his hour had come, that he should depart out of this world to the Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end.
이 말씀을 영접하시기를 바랍니다.
He loved them to the
감사합니다.
end. Please receive these words just as they are.
하나님,
thank you. Let's pray.
예수님이 이 땅에 와서 마지막 고난 주간
Jesus came to this earth and
walked
this Passion Week, the last week.
저희들이 and we have come upon the 주의 심정을 this Passion Week. 만이 하나라도 조금이라도 헤아리고 깨닫는 복과 은혜 주신 것 감사합니다. 이 땅에 오셔서 주님 얼마나 많은 눈물을 흘리고 땀을 흘리고 저희들이 와야 밤잠을 자지 못하고 주무시지 못하고 기도하시는 주님 모습이 저희 눈에 성경 말씀 볼 때 소원합니다. 가는 곳마다 핍박과 역설과 쫓김과 오해와 환난과 또한 죽였다는 이런 증오와 충만한 것도 비로소 알았습니다. 저희들이 아무리 괴로워도 주님의 괴로움에 거기에 비교할 때가 있겠습니까? 주님이요 이제는 그 나라와 그 의를 위해서 주님을 위해서 이 땅에 숨을 쉬고 먹고 마시고 사는 믿음의 맛을 볼 수 있도록 축복하여 주셨소서. 근본 성인을 통해서 떡떡이 확실하게 은혜 받는 복 받는 역사가 있게 하여 주시옵소서. 근본 고난 중한 때 예수의 마음을 몽땅 선물로 받는 역사가 있게 하여 주시옵소서. 근본 고난 중한 때 가정의 어려움과 자식들 남편 안에 모든 삶의 어려운 문제가 하나님께서 기적을 베풀어서 말끔히 해결시켜 주셨소. 아브라함 아들 이삭이가 블레셋 땅에 있을 때에 말할 수 없는 어려운 한파를 만나서 괴로움을 당했습니다. 그러나 하나님 앞에 기도하고 의지하고 농사 질 때에 그의 100배의 수확권을 얻었다고 창세기 26장 11절 이야기도 보겠습니다. 그 말씀이 우리 고난 중간에 우리 평강교회 그늘에서 신앙사는 모든 성도에게 해당될 수 있도록 축복하여 주셨소서. 근본 고난 중간 때 가정가정마다 병자가 있습니까? 말씀으로 물리쳐 주셨소서. 예수님의 몸을 빌어서 모든 병마 다 깨끗하게 물리쳐 주시옵소서. 모든 병마는 깨끗하게 씻어 주시옵소서. 기도한 대로 이루어질 줄로 확실하고 믿으면서 감사하면서 모든 말씀 빌고 오나올 때에 존귀하신 예수님의 이름을 받들어 감사 기도 올려옵나이다. 아멘.